Hey guys, it's Haley, Cosmetology 120 Lab, and today we are going to do waxing of the brow and upper lip. So we're going to start by greeting our client, escorting them to the work area, and looking at their current style, talking about their preferences, and anything they're expecting to get out of today's service. Then we want to do a skin analysis on the client. We're looking for skin that is irritated, inflamed, broken, raised, swollen skin in the area to be worked on. We are looking for open wounds and sores in the area to be worked on, as well as infection or infestation such as lice in the area to be worked on today. If the client is free from all of that, we're going to go ahead and go to the consultation form. In the consultation form, we are discussing with the client any medications or products they've used in the last 72 hours. We're going to talk about any known allergies that the client has. We're going to discuss any facial surgeries they've had within the last 3 months. And we are going to discuss if they remain under a doctor's care for those. We're going to ask the client if they are prone to fever blisters or cold sores. And we are going to talk about any exfoliation products or skin lightening agents they've used within the last 72 hours, such as AHAs and BHAs. And we are going to discuss if the client has had any facial injections within the last 3 weeks, such as Botox or hyaluronic fillers. If the client is free from all of those, then we would go ahead and move forward with today's service. And we're going to start by washing our hands. So, wetting our hands under warm running water and lathering with liquid antibacterial soap. Rinsing with warm running water. Drying with a disposable paper towel. Turning off the water with that paper towel and disposing of that in the trash. Then we are going to sanitize our hands. And we're using hand sanitizer that is between 62 and 70% ethyl alcohol. And this particular brand is 70%. barbicide wipes. And these are EPA registered, verified effective as a vermicidal, fungicidal, bactericidal agent. They are approved for use in the spa and salon setting. So wipe number one, we are cleansing and sanitizing our work area. We are going to wipe down our lamp as well as our wax warmer. Go ahead and plug both of those in. Make sure they're properly working. And wipe down our cart. Dispose of that. We have wipe number two, and this one is for disinfection. So once the first wipe has dried for 2 minutes, we're going to go ahead and wipe with wipe number two. And again, wipe number two is our disinfectant. So we're wiping down a workstation, wiping down our lamp, wiping down our wax warmer, and just checking to make sure that it is on, heating up properly. Should be good to go by now. And then we're gonna wipe down our cart one more time. Of our gloves. All right, now we are going to gather the items that we're going to need for today. So I have gloves available. I have a hip band for my client. I have cotton pads right here on my cart, as well as my small scissors. And tweezers. Wooden wax applicator sticks I have right here in my cart, so I'm not going to get a whole bunch of them out, I don't think. And then table paper. For the bed, which this is going to serve as our table paper today. And we need a drape for our client. And I will have a towel to put under her head. And then I need wax strips, which are also available on my cart. I am going to need some disposable cups, which I have here. And we're going to fill these. So I have my pre-epilation cleanser. This is my post-epilation wax remover. I'm going to leave these out so we can cleanse them. Cornstarch. Post-epilation soothing gel. And this is going to serve as our wax today. And this is honey. Then we are going to help our client onto the table. And before we get started, we're going to wash our hands again. So washing our hands with warm running water and liquid antibacterial soap. Rinsing in warm running water. Drying with a disposable paper towel. Turning off the water with that paper towel and disposing of it in the trash. Sanitizing our hands. Thank you. we're going to use a disposable mascara wand to determine the growth pattern of the hair. And also making sure that they're clean and that all of the makeup has been removed. They're all brushed up. Just trim it around. And that's going to go there to be disinfected. Testing the wax on our wrist to make sure that it's not too hot. Are applying the wax in the direction of the hair growth. Holding the skin taut, quickly removing it in the opposite direction. We're going to talk with our client about maintenance and aftercare. And all of these items would be put into our to be disinfected. Not to be disinfected, but to be laundered. This would all be disposed of, and our tray would be disinfected. And this is items to be disinfected as well. And we're going to clean with our Barbasol wipes again. So I have wipe number one, and we're wiping down the workstation. Wiping down our lamp. Warmer. Wiping down our product bottles. Getting wipe number two. This would dry for 2 minutes. And then we have wipe number two, and this is our disinfectant. We're disinfecting the area this time. And then we're going to wash our hands, so wetting our hands under warm running water, lathering with liquid antibacterial soap. sitting under warm running water. Drying with a disposable paper towel. Turning off the water with that paper towel and disposing of that in the trash. And then we are sanitizing our hands with ethyl alcohol hand sanitizer with a 70% active ingredient.